Hey everyone, it's Kabir here. So in today's session, we are going to understand about the folder structure of React application. As in last session, we have created one React application named as app1. Now let us understand what that folder structure meant for. See, whenever you are going to open this application, the first folder you are going to see as a node module. This is a folder created. And this folder is going to contain lot of the files. So whatever you are going to download from NPM registry, all that library or the files are going to come and store in your node modules. So that is the purpose of your node modules. It is used to store your third party libraries that comes from your NPM registry. Next folder, we have the public. Public have some icon, some JSON file, some images, all that. And one important file we have index.html. This index.html is going to load in your browser. This is the only page is going to load in your browser whenever you are going to run your React.js application. Now in this page, like in this HTML page, you have a tag known as div tag, which is on the line number 31. So whatever the components you are going to create for user interface, that all the components are going to come and reside in this div tag only. Okay, so we are going to see the components in this div tag. It might be mounting or demounting. Mounting is nothing but the like your component going to display, and demounting is nothing but it is going to remove. Right? Depends upon our actions. That everything we will be seeing in the detail. So as of now, just you have to remember index.html is the only page which is going to load in your browser. And in this page, we have one tag known as div tag. So in this div tag, all your components are going to come and reside. Okay, as of now, you have to remember this much. So once you're done with this public folder, we have the src folder. This is the actual folder of your application. So here we have app.cs, app.js, app.test.js. Okay, this is nothing but one component. It is a predefined component created by the React people. So whenever you are going to create one React application, by like predefined component will be created, and it is going to come implicitly with that application. Okay, so what app.css is nothing but this is a one CSS file. So whatever style you want to give to that particular component, that stylings you are going to write in this particular file, app.css. Then next is app.js. Your execution is going to start from index.js, but your main app is nothing but main component. Whatever logic you want to write in that component, that logic you are going to write in app.js. We'll be seeing everything as a step by step. Just you have to remember app.js is nothing but one component which has been created by the React.js people. It's a predefined component. We are going to create our own component, and that component are called custom components, right? Cool. Now next we have app.test.js. This is used for the testing purpose. So as of now, we don't require. Next is the thing, index.css. This file is required to give some styling to the page, which is going to load in your browser. Which page is going to load in your browser? index.html. If you want to give some style to that page, that logic we are going to write in this particular file, that is index.css. And next we have the index.js. Your React.js application execution is going to start from this file, index.js. You have to remember. So for that purpose, first of all, we have to understand some libraries, okay? Some functions like what is React DOM, okay? You have to understand what is this app, how we have to represent one component. So that things we have to do. So as of now, just remember index.js is the starting point for your execution of your application. Now, once you're done with index.js, then we have some service worker.js setup test. We will be seeing this later in the after sessions, because as of now we don't require. Now next we have the package.json. This is nothing but whatever libraries you are going to install that are going to come and register, like we are going to register here. So if you install any third party library, so first you have to install, like first you have to register that particular library in one file, and that file is package.json. okay, so every package.json contains, like, what is the name of your application. It contains all the details of your application. This is the name, what is the version, okay, what are the dependencies, okay, what are the scripts you are using, okay, all these things is resided in this particular file. So this is all about your folder structure of React.js. Like, it's like overall I have given, like, not in that depth, but overall picture of how the folder structure is going to look of React.js you have to understand. So the main thing what you have to understand here is, like, you have to know what is node modules. Okay, now you have to know what is public, and in that public you have to know what is index.html. we told index.html is the page which is going to load in your browser. This is only the page which is going to load in your browser. That's why we call React.js apply, like, using React.js we can create single page applications, that is SPA applications, right? Now when it comes to SRC, you have to, like, know that app.js is nothing but one predefined component which came with your application which is already created. Now how can we create our own components? That we will be seeing in some other sessions. Okay, now we have to understand what is index.js. this is the starting point from where your execution is going to start. So I will be explaining in next session, like, we have to we have to understand few things. We have to understand what is component. Once you have understood few concepts, then I can tell you what is the flow, like how it is going to execute, what are the steps, like from one file to another file, how it is going. That everything we will be seeing in some other sessions. Okay, and package.json, which is going to, like, you are going to give the, it is going to give the details of your application. What is the name, what are the version, and what are the dependencies you are using, all that, and whatever the dependencies you want to use, just you have to register it. Like, manually you don't need to register. When you have one command, just use that command, automatically it is going to come and register here. As of now, whenever you are going to create the application, it is going to, like, some scripts it is going to download, and some dependencies also it is going to download and install, and that are registered. Like React is one dependency, like React DOM, React scripts. This we will be, like, learning step by step, what is React, what is React DOM, what is React script, what is the purpose of that all thing. So in for this session it's enough. So just remember a few things. Thank you guys.